Right, well, good afternoon. What I'd like to talk to you about today is technology. Technology's impact on business, economic development, and arguably through a technological revolution, society today. What we're seeing more and more these days, particularly in the developed nations, is a commitment from government. So for example, the UK government, David Willetts, who's the Minister for Business Information and Skills, has made, I think, a rather exciting statement that many of the universities are now responding to, that we need to reshape the economy. And he is encouraging us to think about connecting to the innovation and research base here in the UK to give us competitive differentiated advantage. And that will be in global challenges such as low carbon technologies, that might be renewables, and some dimensions that might be a new generation of nuclear power. And it certainly means things like major investment in infrastructure. But of course, it touches life sciences, cell therapy, advanced manufacturing, and advanced informatics. So when we hear ministers starting to put their colours out into such a domain, then we can see that the commitment from the public sector and the policy leadership is going to start enabling innovative companies, be the SMEs with a particular piece of technology, or a large blue chip company that thrives on innovation like Rolls-Royce in aerospace, like GSK and AstraZeneca in pharmaceutical manufacturing. Their lifeblood is innovation and technological development. So as a consequence, technology is absolutely of its time. And universities such as Strathclyde University, a leading international technological university, has an opportunity now to map our capability in the research labs to make an impact, making companies more competitive, giving them an international advantage, because remember, the world is a very small place these days, and technological innovation can come from a very modest start, let's say in a research lab, but some of the biggest impacting technologies emerge rapidly if they're done in an international context, be that international development teams, or the investment comes from around the world to create, for example, the next generation of tidal and wave devices, the next generation of offshore renewable devices, new manufacturing technologies for drugs to drive the cost down and make it more available to developing nations. So as well as technological innovation for economic development, technology can have a disproportionate impact on society's well-being, making available drugs, making available, very importantly, information. The idea of pervasive communication, be that through satellite comms, broadband, everything through to optical fiber, massive increases in broadband bandwidth capability to get information and data to parts of the world that have been traditionally blocked away from information for business purposes, information for marketing and promotion purposes, but in terms of social justice, very important. And for those of you who may be interested in browsing, I commend Peter Gabriel's organization Witness, as an organization that's using technology to touch the lives of people in parts of the world, be that in sub-Saharan Africa, it could be South America. It may well be that they've had a big impact in the Arab Spring, where they've been using digital technology to allow people to challenge social injustice, violence, and I don't make the comment politically, but perhaps inappropriate use of state power to some ends. So again, at the heart of that, technological development. So for me, the next 20, 25 years, I think we're going to see an acceleration of technological impact nationally and internationally. And then we have to see technology as a means of enabling the major emergence of China, the fast rise of India, who have fantastic universities, who have tremendous students, who they don't only have great students in terms of their intellect, but they have great volumes of students. So the workforce that they're creating are ambitious. They have an international outlook in terms of their ambition, but what they want to do is to get access to international partners, be that education here in places like Strathclyde, or indeed having that experience that they then take back home and have created part of that global framework for us to look at technological development. In this university, for example, one or two examples that I'll mention that could be potentially disruptive are, for example, in the area of photonics. So that might be laser technology, it might be the materials that produce the next generation of lasers, and the application domains are enormously exciting. So for example, using advanced laser technologies in the electronic processing of the signals that they derive from imaging, we have a biophotonics group that are revolutionizing how doctors can image inside the human body. And that might be to determine the onset and development of tumors, all the way through to looking at the impact of certain cell therapies and certain medicines on the organs in the human body. Now, that is a wonderful multidimensional, literally and metaphorically, and multidisciplinary program where we have scientists dealing with advanced materials. We have computer scientists looking at the image processing. We have electronic and electrical engineers helping to develop the algorithms that derive information from the lasers. And here we've got a spark of basic physics understanding in laser techniques that has gone all the way through to impacting on our lives. Another piece of this is in wind energy. Strathclyde University has Europe's biggest academic group in wind technologies. Now, socially, that is still quite a controversial subject. You know, people want low carbon energy to, you know, should we say, address climate change, global warming, but sometimes they're not so comfortable having the visual impact on the surroundings and their environment. But of course, there comes a judgment in society. How do we address the values that drive our policies, but still recognize as a citizen of our nation, and indeed a global citizen, that ultimately we have to take personal responsibility to allow these technologies to emerge and to have an impact. So in this university, you know, we have a major global partnership right across Europe. We have partnerships right through China and in North America. We are now designing the prospective 10 megawatt offshore machines, which is four times the current size of what you'd typically see on land-based systems, and they are rather large. And we're talking about working, not talking about, we are moving to deploying these devices with industry, with government partners who have to assist us in doing this, like the Crown Estate have to allow us to get access to deployment. The regulator, Ofgem, needs to make sure that the regulatory compliance has been addressed, and the investment community need to see a de-risked, insurable set of technologies in order to get these devices in the water. You know, sitting in water that's, you know, 100 feet and deeper, maybe 5, 10, 15 kilometres offshore, we can see that we've got social scientists, humanities experts, economics, engineering, science, technology, regulation, politics, all having to converge around an opportunity that's been driven by technological development. So we can never think about technology independent from society. In fact, technology, policy, economics, and the sociology of that are absolutely fundamentally important for allow us to develop as a nation. Another thought I will raise with you is the whole idea of colleagues in the University of Reading work in cybernetics, and the ethics and the acceptability in the society of embedded technology in the human body is a very interesting challenge, where we might actually be embedding processors in our organs, in our skin, monitoring health, producing data, you know, bioinformatics that allow doctors to, again, check our health, develop where we are. The technology is mature in many of these areas, sensors, communication, all the way down to the design and how we deploy these technologies. But then we need to ask, is society willing to accept this? But of course, if they're willing to accept it, there are major industries to be built. Again, economic development, new jobs, revenues, international profile, that again bundles up this idea of mapping technological innovation, which our policy leaders, you know, we mentioned Mr. Willits and Dr. Vince Cable in Westminster, Mr. Swinney and Mr. Salmond here in Scotland also are very excited and I think genuinely committed to Scotland having technological advances in life sciences and informatics and low carbon energy. Barack Obama is saying the same thing in North America, and indeed Strathclyde recently supported the visit of Vice Premier Li from China, who potentially will be the next premier in China itself. They are interested in technological impact for economic development, sitting alongside the way that their society is going to develop over the next few decades. So there's a, what should we say, a convergence of society, technology, policy and economics that is a very exciting opportunity for all of us. For students studying business, it's very important to be technologically aware, not necessarily to be technical experts. You'll certainly be technical experts in terms of social media, and that's right and proper. And you needn't be an expert in advanced photonics, in electrical power engineering, in computational intelligence, but you need to be aware of what the potential business models are and the societal impact and acceptance models are that allows to build up a value proposition that investors buy into, that generates wealth, that allows us to create industries. And I'd like to think Strathclyde's in the vanguard, along with other very esteemed institutions, of us really driving technological change, but with a social awareness. And the business school that you are studying in, that you're developing your thinking in, is also part of International Technological University, where you get a chance to impact in your understanding of business models, relevance, how we can shape some of these technological propositions into things that have value for society and indeed for business development.